The Wye is one of the most protected and cherished rivers flowing through Wales and England. However, the river and the economy it brings into the area are on the brink of collapse because of the alarming increase in chicken factories along its bank. The factories and the toxic waste they dump into the river are the major reason behind the Wye resembling an open sewer as of late. Let's discuss. First up, where lies the problem? The river flows through two county councils, Hertfordshire and Powys. It's here that the main problem began, and here that the factory farming problems at a steep rise. It's also worth noting that the river accounts for a large portion of their economy through tourism, but more on that in a minute. So, how did the issue begin? The issue began when the counties of Powys and Hertfordshire granted permission for giant steel barns to be built in the area. These barns contain an estimated 20 million birds. That's a staggering amount of birds, and naturally led to a boom in the industry. After a giant processing plant opened in Hertfordshire, it was handling over a million chickens a week, and so, which led to the building of 90 new chicken factories to answer the supply demand. Now for the interconnected disaster and lack of planning. When the aforementioned giant steel barns were approved, it was on the assumption that they'd have little to no immediate impact on the environment. Every decision was taken in isolation, and the cumulative impact they would have was never considered. But of course, the entire pipeline is interconnected, and disaster ensued. Chicken units weren't mentioned in the county development plan when the storage units were being built, but they became a necessity. Chickens die in transit if they are moved too far, so holding units had to be built. Farmers knew this and applied it to build said units. The council at this point had no legal means to stop these builds. On the other hand, foul play was also suspected by conservative politicians, who used delaying tactics to have the chicken units approved before a void in the policy could be addressed. Next, we have the after effects. Now that we've discussed how the issue started, let's take a look at everything that has happened since, starting with the crowfoot problem. 90% to 97% of the river's crowfoot beds have been killed. Crowfoot anchors the entire ecosystem, much like mangroves do in the tropical sea. Due to the excess amount of manure from these huge flocks of birds, the ecosystem has been affected. Manure from the flock is spread by farmers onto their fields, but the grass and soil can only absorb so much. The remaining surplus of nutrients ends up in the river. The crowfoot can't handle the surplus, and what remains of them are threatened by the repeated blooms of single-cell algae, which has been growing like crazy due to the extra nutrients. Now we have the chicken farmers' opinion. The chicken farmers vehemently deny the pollution is their fault. They blame it on other sources. However, science says otherwise. A major study was conducted last month according to which phosphate is the most important mineral killing the river. Where does the phosphate come from? You guessed it. 6,500 tons of phosphate are brought into the catchment every year. Out of this, 5,000 tons arrive in livestock feed. 80% of this is consumed by chickens, and most of it is excreted. So, 3,000 tons more than what can be absorbed by the soil is dumped into the river every year. And herein lies the problem. And now for the chicken mafia. Okay, that sounds a bit dramatic, but hear me out. Chicken factories in these areas are extremely lucrative, with the largest generating a profit of about £1 million each year. So yes, they're loaded. That also explains the vandalism and intimidation tactics being employed against locals that object to the factories and their owners. Some locals even admitted that they were worried someone would get shot or firebombed due to the animosity between the two parties. So if that's not mafia behavior, what is it? Here's the impact on the tourism industry. While the factories have been creating jobs, they've been taking them away too. The River Wye is the focal point for the local economy. The tourist hotspot is a hub for canoeing, angling, swimming, and camping, with support pubs, restaurants, hotels, shops, and many other businesses scattered about. However, now, the river stinks in peak summertime, and swimming in it will leave your skin feeling slimy. So the Wye has been more of an open sewer than a river lately. Now we have the county council responses. The county council of Hertfordshire imposed a planning moratorium around the Wye and its tributary, the Lug. What does this mean? It means that there's a ban on building new houses, restaurants, or any other businesses that might release phosphate in the future. This also means no new chicken factories in Hertfordshire. While Hertfordshire is taking the right step forward, Powys seems to be on a building rampage. 90,000 bird factories were approved in March. This comes at the cost of 20,000 houses that could have been built in the area, which already faces a shortage of housing. When asked about the merits of the decision, a councilman shared that it was subject to legal challenge and refused to comment. Time for some popular sentiments. The situation has reached some popular celebrities as well, with comments in support for saving the river coming in. Author and broadcaster Stephen Fry tweeted about the situation to his 12.1 million followers. "Why, oh why, read and weep," he said, while sharing a link to an article on the situation. Gardener's World presenter and Hertfordshire resident Monty Don also read about the situation and retweeted it, saying that the farm factories must be stopped. And lastly, the people are fighting back. After much disaster and pollution, the people are now fighting back. A crowdfunded case by the people of Golden Valley, Hertfordshire, is to be heard in court soon, challenging the building of yet another livestock unit. It is integral for the people to win this case, since the entire watershed hangs by a thin thread. The The Wye is on the brink of being killed by the factory farming industry near it, and we can only hope that the people can protect it from any more harm coming its way. While the fate of the Wye hangs in the balance, let's discuss some other news as we await more information. First, Powys named number one spot in Wales for accidents involving horses. With 34 horse-related incidents in Powys, the number of incidents is on a 234% rise across Wales. With road accidents involving the four-legged beasts on a rise throughout the UK, the British Horse Society, or BHS, is campaigning to humanize horse riders. A campaign called Look Out for Laura campaign has been created after research by Nottingham Trent University, dedicated to achieving zero serious accidents or deaths on UK roads. The campaign is funded by the Road Safety Trust and aims to create more awareness in drivers about the dangers related to horses on the road. Next, we have thunderstorm warnings in Powys. The Met Office has warned citizens of Powys about torrential downpours, thunderstorms, and potential flooding in the county following the warm spell they've been enjoying. Thunderstorm warnings for the afternoon and early evening in some areas have been shared by a spokesman, with chances of 40 millimeters rain within an hour and 40 to 60 millimeters rain in 2 or 3 hours. These torrential rains will likely be accompanied by gusty winds, hail, and frequent lightning. However, stormy areas can't be pinpointed at the moment. Other areas that have also received a yellow weather warning include Blenheim Gwent, Bridgend, Caerphilly, Cardiff, Denbighshire, Flintshire, Merthyr Tydfil, Monmouthshire, Neath, Port Talbot, Newport, Rhondda Cynon Taf, Torfaen, Vale of Glamorgan, and Wrexham. And finally, a Newtown woman attacks another with a bottle on a night out. Serena Yap, a 23-year-old from Llanaithin, Newtown, had been in the news last year after she had struck a woman with a bottle at the steam mill. The incident occurred on October 3rd during the early hours of the day. Yap appeared at Welshpool Magistrates Court this week and admitted a charge of unlawfully and maliciously inflicting grievous bodily harm without intent. Following the admission, the court committed the case to Mold Crown Court, citing not having sufficient sentencing power to deal with the case in the lower court. According to the prosecutor, Helen Tench, Megan Williams was having a smoke outside with her boyfriend, Ryan Groves, and friend Manon Jones. During an altercation with an ex-coworker from Morrison's, Serena lunged at Megan with an orange bottle in her hand and slashed it across her face. The attack left her with an open cut on her forehead that reached tissue and bone, and left her with a permanent scar on her face. Yap didn't say anything during or after the statement, and had pleaded guilty at the first opportunity, shared Owen Jones, her representative. She's due to appear for a sentence at Crown Court in Mold on Tuesday, July 5th. That's a wrap for this video. Do you think the people will be able to save the River Wye from further pollution? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this.